And they're really really mildly maintained. So we have facies A, which is the yellow color, is a muddy facies, backstone to waterstone. It's contained within facies B, which is backstone to brainstone facies, which is B is the sheet and A is the muddy channels. And then when this is the lower part of the sequence, which is the lower part sequence. And then the sharp surface here, this is the sheet zone. Above it, we find facies C, which is grating channels, the opposite of this one. A was muddy channels. C is grating channels dissected through facies D, which is muddy facies or muddy sheet. So we have grating sheet B and muddy sheet D. And inside them, there's muddy channels A and grating channels C. C are small channels, but C is laterally continuous channels and extended for longer distances. Here we documented the locations of our measured sections. This is section A, section B, C, D, E, F, and G. And these are our sections that we measured. And here south, the southern part is the uplift, and another part towards the Mediterranean Sea is the downlift. These species, they have another criteria. As you go down there, the amount of mud content increases. The same thing happens as you go upwards in the section, the amount of the mud increases. Here's the sedimentary features, detailed look at the sedimentary features. We find here beds that are massive at the bottom, and then laminated, cross-laminated, and then laminated again. And as you go up, the mud content increases up. So we find out these are polymer sequences, TA, TB, TC, cross-laminated, and then TB. Repeat again, TA, TB. As you go up, this is erosional surface, TA, and then laminated. This section was up there. The same thing repeated here, down there. We find TA, massive, TB, laminated, TC, convoluted beds, and TB, laminated again. And then the same thing repeated. This section is down there. So the first, the BOMA sequences documented first time in 2017. They know it's turbidite or slope deposit, but the scale of these sequences was really small, very centimetric, and everybody looking for huge BOMA sequences, but nobody looked at this small scale. The next, here we have the stealth turbidite sequences, but we have chert modules, flattened chert modules. Some places we find them gray color, some places we find them since the calcified chertly dunes, so we have that. This grainy turbidite, it has large grains, which is carbonate lithoclastics. You can see it here, and you see it more here, carbonate lithoclastics. And those carbonate lithoclastics decrease in amount and size as you go up in the section, from conglomerate size to coarse to medium sand size. Here you see the smiley face, which is the channel, the small channels that dissected the turbidite sheets. So these are the features. Also in the field, we notice that we have sharp surface. You see this sharp surface? And here we have the reflow. This here, chaotic texture, has a lot of these coarse conglomerated carbonate lithoclastics. And then again, this is up there. And these sediments here are structureless, massive. As you go down, we're still above this shear zone. This is the lower power sequence, and then above the shear zone, the upper power sequence. You see TA, TB, TA, TB, TA, TB, repeated bomb sequences. And this part is undisturbed. But as you go down here, Cretaceous be the grainy one. In the upper part of sequence, you find the grainy channel, Cretaceous C, contained within the muddy fishes or the muddy sheet. So here, you have thin sections for the upper one, the lower one, sorry, and thin sections for the upper part of sequence. So what we see here, we see like there was intergranular porosity, leaching, and filled by sporite, and then later we have fractures, which is the blue colors here, that enhances the color porosity and permeability. This is the summary of my work. I just left it there for people to help them to understand the presentation, but I'm saying it now. Okay, so we put all this or these elements together, sedimentology, stratigraphy, petrography, gravitational elements, structural elements, all together, all these observations together to understand what's going on and what's or how these factors affected on my reservoir quality, connectivity. So the results that we came up with for depositional facies. They are carbonates, but textually different. These four facies, we have facies A, which is the channel finding upward, is limestone, limestone, so muddy. Muddy channels incorporate the grainy facies, forcing upward cycle, and then this is the lower sequence. The upper sequence, we have the grainy channels incorporated in muddy sheets. Okay? The second result, the whole sequence, 8.7 meters, is just one finding upward sequence made up of two part sequences, the lower one grainy, the upper one is muddy. And then the third result, the turbidite sequence that made up of BOMA sequences, the whole sequence made up of stacking BOMA sequences on unit scales, it shows massive structures up there, undisturbed section in the middle. As you go down there, you will find the slump structure. And the other thing in these BOMA sequences, intensively fractured. Up there, you will see a lot of normal faults. Down there, you will see a lot of reverse faults, plus the pop-up structures. The other results, mud content increases downwards and upwards in this section. And the BOMA sequences themselves, the lower part sequences, none of them is deforming, but if you go in the upper part sequences, the muddier one, you will find BOMA sequences deformed. So the deformation was restricted to the muddier part sequence, not to the grainy one. And the other piece of information we noticed, the BOMA sequences, as you are up there, they are TA, TB, mostly grainy. But if you go down there, you'll find TA, TB, TC, up to TD, more complete section. But TD, I didn't see it. Maybe you wrote it. Okay? The other result that the lower bar sequence dominated by fragmented forams. We have a lot of fragments, more than intact forams. But the upper one, the muddier one, has more intact forams and less fragmented forams. So the sedimentary structures, which is mainly made, you know, that made the BOMA sequences, are massive lamination, cross lamination, and then we see larger ones, soft sedimentary deformation, which is the slump, and we see besides the slump some other channels. So these are the main sedimentary features that we noticed in the field. The conclusion: what do we understand from the whole story? These structural, gravitational, sedimentological, stratigraphic elements. How to, you know, digest them, our brain. So came up with this story that old Cyrenaican, late Cretaceous, Lathrun formation, is turbidite. The whole sequence is turbidite. Okay? And it's made up of four facies. And these four facies, carbonate facies, build smaller centimetric scale bomber sequences that stacked above each other to form two parasequences. The lower parasequence was grainy, the upper one was muddy. And both together, the two parasequences gave me the whole sequence, which is final upward sequence. And then this whole turbidite species, bomber sequences, subjected to post-depositional gravitational processes that, you know, showed us the sliding, the slumping, and the debris flow processes. So, like the turbidites itself, re-sedimented, but in a plastic and brittle form. We didn't reach like the fluidization stage. Facial quality, now this is a little more. Facial quality, as we said, mud content increased down there and up there. That's decreasing our facial quality as a reservoir. But the channels, they do the opposite. The channels in the lower part were muddier, but as you go up, became grainier and laterally more continuous. So channels behave differently than the sheets. And the upper channels grainier and sealed by that muddy sheet. The later brittle deformation enhances my porosity and permeability and make the whole sequence has higher permeability and higher porosity, but we lost the seal, the muddier the sheet here. And so, as a conclusion, the whole late Cretaceous, Al-Athrun formation, late Cretaceous formation, deposit as a turbidite, altered by gravitational process. We didn't know the main reason was like gravitational caused by seismic tectonics or by loading or sediment weight, something. So those turbidite conditions altered by the gravitational process, those processes and the latter or the late latter fracture and faults, it changed my facies distribution, facies geometry, and the facies conductivity as a reservoir. So my facies and my Cretaceous, late Cretaceous turbidite facies were controlled by depositional and gravitational or post-depositional gravitational process and times. Thank you very much.
Was not aware of the turbidites